Today, we're counting down our picks for the most scintillating look out for romantic spoilers. Were one of the longest running relationships, and perhaps one of the couples played for the most part. Leo entered the charm of his life and he was assigned by heavenly beings like the elders to be the sisters of Leo, or Jordan. Nightlighters and witches were forbidden from being involved in magic. The connection between Piper and Leo was just too strong to ignore.
How do you feel about guys who are
a lot of roadblocks when it comes to dating.
You can still get adopted. I'll stay at my dad's. See each other there.
And everybody's back. The romantic feelings between Brandon and Callie seem to be the worst. Brandon acted on these feelings very early. Callie was more hesitant than that if she became involved with imposter something,
I don't just mean this for you. You and the police. We're having to do it. We're not going to
do it. The team ultimately ended up pressing down the plans for the other team shippers. But rally shippers out there in the world still pulled out hope that something might be impossible for these two to be on the same side.
Rally to
Grayson and David Clark. Revenge. Revenge was a great story. It is surprising as the relationship between Victoria Grayson and Victoria was part of the reason that David Clark was framed for the crash of Great Wonders. This information from most of the series run. But then romance threw a wrench in what we had. Now, before the series, Victoria and David engaged in an affair that resulted in the birth of Victoria's incest.
So you mean that she's my daughter? You paid everything.
She is Brandon. Victoria was forced by Conrad to leave her, and she ends up deeply affected by her actions throughout the course of the show. Not gonna lie. You can lie to me. It demands absolute honesty. Number 17. Lee, Apollo, Adama, and Carol Starbuck Grace. That was not the last one. Did you see me?
All I meant was...
No, seriously. Very sweet. You got the
hasn't fallen into a complicated yet loving relationship with their dead fiancé's brother. No? Does Carol Grace mean? Well, it might not be normal, but it's certainly made for compelling television.
It is in too.
I mean, it's in there.
complexities between Paraphrase and Neodamus were way before the events of Battlestar Galactica. Any chance of a romance between the two seems impossible because Thomas is engagement to his daughter. Even more than that, the two are so completely different. Sometimes, those differences are the things that make them seem desperate. Number 16, Alicia Corrick and Bill Harper. Workplace relationships are taboo for you, but when your chemistry is as hot as it is, maybe exceptions should be made. Throughout The Good Wife, Will makes his attraction to Alicia Corrick. Taking revenge on his brother and doing some trouble. The two start off as foes, but eventually that animosity turns into a friendship and later love.
This will prove to be the worst one, but I am not sorry.
Number 14, Harry Matheson and Nicholas Brody. Homeland. Working for the CIA, it's probably a given that you shouldn't become romantically involved with someone who has a reputation for privilege. But on Homeland, Harry Matheson was never one to come back.
All of them.
She takes an investigation into her own hands, looking into a possible POW to establish a outside of CIA protocol. She eventually strikes up a romantic relationship with her. The meat of much of the first few seasons of the show. Now, this relationship isn't a great idea, but you could cut that tension with me. Number 13, Leslie Nope and Ben White. Doesn't show up on Parks and Recreation until the end of season 2, but it's hard to imagine the show without his and Leslie's incessant dating. They are explicitly forbidden from dating each other, and Leslie's bid for simply a show doesn't necessarily leave a lot of time for romance. Despite the setbacks they face, however, it's on the good show we always let each other
do this. How would you imagine we do this?
Up to your job and realize that you're on my stand, it's a bus.
Are you calling me out this morning?
Because both of them are new. Later, you're maybe starting to get used to the idea of being in the house. Then, your boyfriend slash boss's estranged wife shows up. This is the kind of thing that Meredith Grey is dealing with.
He's a brain surgeon. How can he be so brainless?
Seriously. Despite all those early hurdles for Meredith and Eric Shepherd's forbidden moments, they quickly become one of the show's most beloved characters. Meredith's speech is still one of the most iconic moments in television history.
Pick me. Love me.
Number 11, Fleabag and the Priest. Being a man of the cloth? Well, that's probably about as forbidden as you can get. She's never stopped Fleabag before, and she's not about to let them stop her now. The second season of Phoebe Waller-Bridge's amazing show Fleabag was somehow better than its first. A lot of that had to do with the introduction of Andrew Scott's affectionately nicknamed Hot Mess. Affairs certainly count as her family. Lily Townsend Bailey at the diner where she works as a waitress. He's a happily married man. Or at least Allison herself is trying to get her life back to her. While cheating isn't cool, and unlike others on this list, aren't they happy to be
married too?
Last supernatural we saw across the universe, Cole and Phoebe got off to a fight, as half-demon soldier Belphegor was sent after the Charmed Sisters by the Trial. However, his human side of nature fell in love with Phoebe, and it began to be his dominant trait. Sadly, things couldn't stay good. And Nadia Jessica. This dynamic and game-changing series for the 2000s pushed the boundaries of long-form storytelling in new ways, with converging characters carrying the addictive, if at times convoluted plot. One such character is Saeja Ra, one of the Ocean of the Six. Number 7, Ned and Charlotte Chuck Charles, Pushing Daisies. Through a body bag anymore, they are still playing a dangerous game. Number 6, Tom Branson and Sybil Crawford, Downton Abbey. This is the classic tale of two lovers from opposite sides of the tracks. Have progressive views, but from the other half, she meets Tom Branson, the new chauffeur. It seems that I'm not.
Baby, I'm sexist. I won't be a chauffeur. I won't always be a chauffeur.
An Irishman and outspoken socialist. He is a bit against everything the Crawley family represents in society. The stump speeches and the who's still jumping into bed is another thing. Washington, D.C. is a hotbed of secrets and political one-upmanship, and despite all the things Grant into the Oval Office, an extramarital affair could mean the undoing of him. Number 4. Dianara is Orange is the new black. Every relationship has its own power dynamic as two partners figure each other out. Situations where the balance is already unnaturally tipped, romantic relations are not typical. Said, this is a forbidden romance list, and Bennett is an undeniable truth. John Bennett is, or was, a correctional officer at the time. Diane Diaz is an inmate.
You most likely live in a place that doesn't.
You shared interests as well as had a physical attraction to? Did that person turn out to be your high school teacher? Well, this is the situation that Ezra Fitz and Aria Montgomery find themselves in. Aria tries to do what she feels is the wrong thing, asking to be transferred out of the cute young prof's class because she doesn't think she can help her.
Transfer out of class.
But the stars align in different relationships. Professor student relationships are highly valued. We're sure glad we got Ezra this time. Compton and Silky Stackhouse.
Good luck.
Not gonna work.
The only thing more complicated than friends becoming first when one of them is a vampire, of course. Even in a world where vampires have come out into the open, the situation is fraught with peril and so many ups and downs we don't even know where to begin.
What are you?
Silky Stackhouse is a half fairy, half human. Compton is a 150-plus-year-old man. You'd think their supernatural status would be enough. In the end, there is a love story marred by tragedy, betrayal, redemption, and Number one, Buffy Summers and Vampire
Slayer.
Buffy doesn't just slay some serious vampire fight. She looks good doing it. The teenage slayer is stumped there for her when she encounters Angel. Josh's indifference turns to attraction, as it becomes apparent that Anna seems odd, at least for a time, when they consummate their love and his soul is suddenly lost. Things get real bad real fast. It's been 20 years, and you're still not over the tragedy that was become. And cue the ceremony. If you miss any of your favorite illicit affairs, let us know. Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other amazing video on YouTube. And be sure to subscribe and like and comment about our latest videos.
Welcome to Watch Mojo. Today, we're looking at the best of real-time strategy software that's offered. We're keeping it limited to one entry per franchise, so only the finest entries. Number 20.
The really bubbles.
Sometimes, it's good to be bad. That's how it goes in dungeons. We take control of the players create dungeons that expand as the game goes on, eventually taking over.
This is out.
Although it starts slowly, building up the dungeons occurs a definite sense of control. Fans are made intimately familiar with the map, expanding off enemy attacks that unlock new areas. Quirky dark humor and an equally quality multiplayer add another layer to the game. Eventually, players craft a complex, rewarding background that pays off the many hours invested in the game. Number 19, Halo Wars.
This is out.
The Halo series took a stab at the RTS genre with Halo Wars. It isn't the most revolutionary of titles, but it gets all the basics right.
So, instead of Halo Wars battle, players navigate to a first world, which allows them to see the world as an accurate and huge force in real time.
The Halo series has attacks launched from all sides, which means aggression is key. different modes of attack have the same power responses every weapon has as a weakness. Because of this, players have to figure out which styles and which is the weakness. While it goes hard, Halo Wars is user-friendly, making it a great option for those who use it. Number 18, Stellaris. Stays true to the 4X's genre. Players can explore, expand, exploit, or